better watch what you say. You better watch what you do to me. Don't get carried away. Girl, if you can do better than me, go. Yeah, go. But remember, good love is hard to find. Good love is hard to find. You got lucky, babe. You got lucky, babe. When I found you, you put a hand on my cheek. And then you turned your eyes away. If you don't feel complete, if I don't take you all of the way, then go. Yeah, go. But remember, good love is hard to find. Good love is hard to find. You lucky, babe. You got lucky, babe. When I found you, yeah, go. Just go. But remember, good love is hard. But I found you. You got lucky. From Tom Petty and the Heartbreakers. In the early 1980s, I think probably 1982-ish. So welcome my veteran friends and all my friends who have tuned in to learn this kind of easy strumming campfire version of You Got Lucky. So I'll start off by telling you, as you've probably already seen, we're using the singer guitarist's best friend, the capo. We're using a full capo on the third fret. And the reason for that is it gets me into a comfort zone with my voice. Typically when I put one of these lessons together that involves a capo, I'll try it on probably three adjacent frets to where I think I might be. So the original version of this is you would have to capo on the fifth fret.
You better watch what you say. You better watch what you do to me.
So that's a little high for me. So I played around, tried it on the second fret, third fret, and I varied back and forth. But for me, actually, the third fret in a G minor rather than the fifth fret in an A minor works better for my vocal range. But you might want to play around. You might find that if your voice is lower than mine, just take the capo off and play it in a straight up E minor. But anyway, we've got a full capo on the third fret. So let's talk about the strum pattern. So it's a simple down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up. That's the foundation. But what I do is I play a bass note on the one and the three. Bass up, down, bass, bass, down, up, bass up, 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 down, up. So you get the idea. So fairly simple strum pattern, and one that I've used a lot. It's kind of the way I do songs. I don't like doing like to vary up the sound. You might even notice that I'm moving kind of up and down across the strings. That's just the way I do it, and I unconsciously did that for years, but as I started doing these lessons on YouTube, I've gotten a lot of questions about that. So yeah, it's something I've done without even knowing I was doing it for the longest time. But so anyway, so with the chords in this song, we start off with the E minor. You better watch what you say. And then we go to an A minor. So that's a 5-string chord, so the bass note is the 5th string. You better watch what you... D chord. Now the bass note is on the 4th string. Do to me. Back to the E minor. Don't get carried away. Back up to the A minor again. Girl, if you can do D better than me. Back to the E minor. Go. Then it works in a C. Go. But remember G. Good love. E minor. Hard to find. G. Good love. E minor. It's hard to find. You got lucky, babe. And then right here, to embellish that C chord, I'll pull my index and my middle off on an up strum. So, you got lucky, babe. You got lucky, babe. And then I'll pull the middle finger off on the D. Play that D sus 2. Let's go back. You got, and the C, lucky, babe. I think I've showed you everything that you need to know how to play the song. So let's close with the last verse. And the chorus. You put a hand on my cheek, and then you turned your eyes away. If you don't feel complete, if I don't take enjoy singing and playing. You got lucky. If you have any questions, feel free to leave me a question in the comments section on YouTube. I'm pretty good about reading all comments and responding whenever there's a question. So have a fantastic week, and I look forward to sending you another lesson very soon. Until then, adios, my friends.